Corrine Bramson, an elderly Florida woman, was placed into hospice without any terminal illness and was overdosed on morphine. Elizabeth Fairbanks, a disabled Californian, was denied antibiotics for a treatable pneumonia and instead was overdosed on morphine. Lawrence Yetzer, a man disabled from birth, was put on drugs which paralyzed his ability to breathe independently, then was overdosed on morphine. These murders took place within the United States and were never prosecuted. Why? Because each of these individuals had a professional, court-authorized guardian who was protected by a legal system which tacitly approves the murder of the elderly and disabled. Today, we have been handed a stunning opportunity to confront the United States on its human rights abuses such as these, and to do so on the world stage. My name is Janet Phelan. I am a journalist, author, and human rights defender. In 2010, for the first time in history, the United States agreed to submit to a review of its record of human rights by the United Nations. In response to this opportunity, Dr. Catherine O'Loughlin and I formed a grassroots organization, which we named Ithaca, for the purposes of submitting a report to this first round of reviews. The second such review will take place this coming April in Geneva, Switzerland, at the Palais Nationes. Accordingly, Ithaca submitted a paper to this meeting, updating our original report on guardianship abuse and attacks on human rights defenders. The rules of engagement are different this time. Representatives from NGOs will be given an opportunity to have the floor and verbally and publicly address the state party under review. The convention room will be filled with representatives from human rights groups and also media. Due to this unprecedented opportunity to publicly confront the United States with its human rights abuses, I plan to travel to Geneva in April. I need your support to make this trip. Ithaca has no official financial support from any sector, and in order to travel to Switzerland for this historic week-long meeting, I am asking for your donations. Please visit janetphelan.com to donate via PayPal. For other options, please contact me directly through my website. The potential impact of such a presentation is massive. For those who believe the U.S. has grown so powerful, so arrogant, that it simply does not care what civil society may say, I would like to remind you of the impact of my other trip to Geneva. In 2011, I addressed the Biological Weapons Convention at the United Nations in Geneva and blew the whistle on the U.S.'s illegal and aggressive biological weapons program. In response to my presentation, the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, made a surprise, unscheduled appearance at the BWC the very next day in what was obviously an attempt at damage control. This was notably the first time ever that a Secretary of State had ever addressed the BWC. There are mounting concerns in many circles that the U.S. may be planning an event which may result in the deaths of many U.S. citizens. I submit that we need look no further than what is happening to the elderly and disabled in adult guardianships to realize that the U.S. has embarked on a systematic plan for eugenics. We can stop this now, or we can wait until the demon is at our own door. I want to thank all of you for what you are doing to get our country back on track. This is Janet Phelan in Chiapas, Mexico. Thank you.